Everyone has been talking about the amazing capabilities of GPT-5, but most of them have forgot that OpenAI has also released another two models along with it, which is GPT-5 Mini and GPT-5 Nano. So in this video, we are going to compare the responses for GPT-5, GPT-5 Mini and GPT-5 Nano, a lot of coding prompt and lead code problems. So let's get started. So this is going to be my first prompt: create me snake egg eater game in HTML and make it the best game ever made by a human. So I have asked this prompt in ChatGPT, which is currently having GPT-5, and just look at the response. 400 lines of code, and let's see what it has given. Let me just click on run code. So this is the interface that we are getting. We are having so many options over here: sound, resume, restart, classic, walls, obstacles, rush, some power-ups. So this is obstacles, we are getting something, and I guess by rush the speed will be much more faster when compared to the other options, and we are having some power-ups also. So it looks so good, to be honest. Like, okay, I need to get that one. Okay, it's not okay, it does edit. So it looks so good, to be honest, like the number of options that it has given me, because I didn't mention any of these in my prompt. I just gave a single sentence and it has done a perfect job as usual. So now let's go to GPT-5 Nano. Pasting the code, open a new tab. Okay, I don't see the game at all, but it has beautifully generated the interface. Everything looks fine, but I just cannot play. I'm not having anything over here. So this is what GPT Nano has given for the same prompt. Let's see finally what GPT-5 Mini has given. Pasting it, open in a new tab. Okay, let me restart. Okay, GPT-5 Mini has done a pretty good job. I really like the interface, how it looks. And we are having a score, best, we are having the sound on and off. We are even having a full screen, like inside the game itself. We are having a progress, and we are having some more. We are even having a hard mode over here. So that's good. And restart option, quite similar to the GPT-5, but I really like GPT-5 Mini's response more than GPT-5 response. So Mini looks so good over here. Next, let's go with this prompt: create a HTML animation with rain effect and lightning, and it needs to be hyper realistic. So let's go with GPT-5 Nano first, and pasting it. Okay, the rain effect looks so good, and the lightning effect is also perfect. Finally, it has given an output, and I really like the rain effect. I don't like know why it is like twisting at the end when falling down. The rain literally goes straight. It's literally going like a snake at the tail part. But apart from that, this is pretty good. GPT-5 Mini, and see what it has given. Okay, that looks good. That looks quite realistic, I would say. I really like this water drops splashing effect. It has gone a bit extra to do this, and the only thing I'm not satisfied here is I don't see any lightning. It's just rain coming over here, but okay, there was a lightning effect, but I like the lightning effect more in GPT Nano than this, and the lightning effect isn't occurring much frequently. Like, you need to wait for a longer time. Apart from that, it has also done a pretty good job. And finally, the main GPT-5, and just look at how many lines of code it has given for a simple rain effect. Okay, that's just insane, the number of lines. It always like surprises me by the amount of response that it gives. And let's see. Okay, damn, just look at that lightning effect. I really like that lightning effect so much, but it doesn't look like rain droplets the way these particles are falling, but I really like the lightning effect. The lightning effect is insane. It looks even better than reality, the lightning effect. Okay, let me go with this prompt: create a HTML code to simulate movement of planets around the sun with animation. GPT-5 Nano, it has thought for 1 minute, but I'm surprised it has given very less output, because for previous prompts it gave a lot of code. Okay, let's see what it has done, and pasting it. Okay, it has done a pretty good job. Yep, that works, that's decent. We have the sun, and the only thing is why the number of planets are less. We are just having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I don't know why the number of planets are less, but It has done a decent job. And now let's see for GPT-5 mini, thought for 5 seconds and it has also given considerable amount of code. Okay, let's see what it does. Okay, just look at the difference between GPT-5 nano and mini. That's so good. Okay, we have a time scale. Okay, just like fast forwarding and stuff. That's really good. And finally, let's go with GPT-5. As usual, it has poured so much of code and let's see what the output looks like. Okay, and wow. Okay, this is the output that we get and just look at it. This is the only thing I guess has covered all the planets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 planets. I guess GPT-5 mini and nano literally gave 5 and I was surprised. I was like confused of my own science, but and all these are moving and we are even getting the information about that scale. So how beautifully it has generated. So what I feel here is GPT-5 nano gives the basic output, like it's quite similar to GPT-4o, but GPT-5 mini and GPT-5 have way more similarities in their response. Like the information that it conveys, it's a level more in GPT-5 mini, and in GPT-5 it's just going all in. It's way more informative and it does that one bit extra. So it's just like the steps. GPT-5 is at the top tier and GPT-5 mini is like one floor down and GPT-5 nano is like another 5 floors down in terms of the output information that it gives. Okay, let's go with this burst balloons lead code hard problem. 60% of acceptance rate, so quite a hard problem. Let's see what all these three models does for this. Okay, let's go with GPT-5 nano if it could solve it, and it has given the output. Okay, let me just copy it. GPT-5 nano has done a great job, beats 97% in runtime and beats 21% in memory. That's so great. Let's go with GPT-5 mini. And in the runtime, GPT-5 mini has got 81%, quite less than nano, but it beats nano 51% in memory. So way better than nano, just a trade-off over there. And finally, let's see what GPT-5 has done. Okay, this is the response that we get from GPT-5, 67% in runtime and 50% in memory. So all three have generated almost similar results for lead code problems. And let me go with another hard problem. So let's go with GPT-5 nano and okay, submit it. It has got 100% in runtime but only 5% in memory. Still that's good for runtime but less in memory. Let's see what the GPT-5 mini has given. 100% and 94%. That's insane from GPT-5 mini. Finally, the main one. And a similar result from GPT-5 also, 100% and 94%. So as a conclusion, what I would say is there isn't any much difference between GPT-5 and GPT-5 mini when it comes to solving lead code problems. Of course, GPT-5 nano has also done a great job in lead coding, but when it comes to creating web apps and creating code for our projects, I think GPT-5 and GPT-5 mini are way more better than GPT-5 nano. And the main difference between GPT-5 and GPT-5 mini is in the details. GPT-5 is a bit more good in detailing and understanding the prompts when compared to GPT-5 mini. So do let me know what you think in the comments. Check the playlist of my channel, learn a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.